Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Umber Bay, and specifically Farvale, where this actually looks really bad right here. I want to smooth this out. I just noticed this on the intro, and I want this not to be like that, because that just looks ridiculous. Just a little. We don't need it, like, super, but just like that. That looks a lot better. This looks cut out, which is the intent, and maybe filled in a little, but that's kind of the intent right there. When it's in the city, it's not really the intent, and bridges just irritate the living flibber out of me. Yes, the living flibber. But today we have a little bit of leveling I wish to do, just to make everything look a little nicer. It's actually good to know that once this is all leveled out, and that's leveling does a little bit of good too, because like right here, it tells me all the water's going to come right here. So I probably want a drain right here to catch all of the water that's going to be coming from any building right there. So leveling is not necessarily a bad thing to do when it's this mountainous, at least. When most of the terrain is flat, it's not going to change it too much because the houses change the ground too. But when it's this mountainous, a little bit of leveling can actually help direct where all the water is going to go. Like, this street is going to be a channel for a lot of water, so I know I'm going to need a lot of drains on this street, specifically. Because, if you look at both sides of the road, we have hills just that roll right into this street. So, we know that right there is going to be pretty much a gigantic river. Let's smooth this out and see what this looks like. You go away, you get pulled out a little bit. Just like that. So once the river gets here, it's gonna kind of get bumped into right here. So yeah, we do need to stop that water as quick as possible right there, that means then. As we don't want it doing that. And it almost looks this very similar over here, where we're just going to get water that's going to flow into the middle. Although the area flattens out over there, and we have a puddle right here, which we do not want. If anything, we should not have any puddles or poodles. No, just kidding. Poodles are fine, but the puddles not so much. There we go. It's not visible, but based on trace lines here and there as I was doing it, the terrain does kind of go this way still from this area. So that's good to know. What about this? What does this turn into? Obviously hilled in this direction, but where does it go beyond? Okay, it will kind of curve at the end into the street, but we might need some drains in between on the back side. That's a puddle. Let's not have that. This side just straight towards the over here. Actually, I think I want to get rid of that road, but I don't know. Meteorologists are issuing a thunderstorm warning for the coming days. This is the only road in which the water probably will actually go into this little river area that we're going to have over here, which that's right, I solved that. Wow, this is very mountainous. Actually, let's get a bit of a bigger tool because this is taking way too long with that itty bitty one, having to go back and forth between all the lines. Okay, so this area is actually just really good because it just flows directly into the this little lake area right here. I might mess with some of the things to actually make it a perpetual lake to which actually makes me want to put a dam in here, but that's not going to work at all in any way, shape, or form. But let's continue the work. So based on that, this entire side is just going to flow this way. So I should expect at least a little bit of flooding. This got really, really messed up, and I don't like smoothing it out like this. But we're going to do it anyways. Yeah, I really don't like that. Can I undo? See, that's part of the issue with Sea Skylines too. If you do something that you don't like, you can't undo it. And I kind of want to undo that and delete this road. Just because it's not very effective to how this city area should be. So pull all that out. And I think that's good for that side at least. Let's pull this side out. Okay, so you're going to be just a giant slip or just a giant hill flowing this way, in which then it just shoves it off into this direction. I don't have to worry about anything really here, but that will just flow down here, which then will flow down into the area down there. So not too worried, not at all. I'll probably have the drain somewhere, like right here or something. But anywho, that's enough of the smoothing. I do believe it's time to pipe it up. Although we do have the issue as well that we need pipes getting up here somehow in general. Just right there and down along that side, I think we'll be fine for the water. That actually gets the entire inside right there, so I'm not going to worry about that too much. Connect it there. This actually needs water up here, so connecting it through here would probably be the best. Down this way, and then like that maybe. 'cause I know redundancy, but it just doesn't work really well right here. yeah, we wanted redundancy right here, though, we could have it very easily like that. There, out to there, to there. We need some right here. Ooh. Let's pause it for that. Let's extend this out, preferably at the 35. And we'll just redundancy it like that. We're almost done here, and we'll see where that sinkhole is going to rear its ugly head. You can have it just down the middle there, and that will get everything just fine. And for redundancy's sake, even though that is a little off, that's good enough. Up here doesn't actually get water. We need some water up here. And I'll place more should we need it, but I don't know if we will. So, where's this sinkhole? Oh. Okay. Out in the middle of the water. That might cause, like, a small tidal wave, but nothing that we actually have to worry about, tell the truth. Not enough goods to sell. Do you guys not order in from outside? Like, seriously. Like, we're not a closed system. We do not need to produce all of our own goods. I get that it's going to reduce profit, but... Oh, gosh. Okay, so we probably should look into having more dirty industry, like up here. We do have some... And the fact that all of the... Or almost all of them are out of food, it just bugs me. I don't know what to do about that. Somewhere in the city. Stay out of harm's way and contact authorities with any information. Wow, that's interesting. Yep, there goes the tidal wave. Or the kind of, because this is how tidal waves are actually created in real life. And actually, if you look at it, you could see how a shockwave actually loses power the further it moves out. This wave is actually getting smaller as it goes out. It's still pretty big, but and it's probably not going to lose enough power by the time it hits the city here, but tidal wave, or a circular one, I guess, because the one that they create is a line, it doesn't lose any power. And it just runs right into the drains, which kind of just eat it. Yeah, that's what actually happens. Right there. This is trying. It's getting up there, but will it actually? No, it won't. Okay. So, kind of an interesting concept. You can kind of see the ring. I'm not even sure if you can see that. My eyes barely picked it out. Like, there's very faint things in which you could which I'm guessing is the tidal wave, and there's some over here too that you could see it, but I'm not sure if YouTube will actually, with all of their compression and rendering and stuff like that, I'm not sure if anybody will actually be able to see that. But let's head back up here because this is what's important at the moment. And I took a look at it. I don't think the city's going to get much bigger. There's a little bit lacking up there, but it's fine. But the reason why the city isn't going to get much bigger, most likely, is that I looked at the expansion mod. Oh, and why are you a bridge? You don't need to be a bridge. Or the one to unlock all of them. And there's kind of a problem. We need to... Citizens are advised to stay indoors. We need to get up to so many people. Like the max level. And I've known this. But we need to get up to the max level of people. And... That's where the problem is. We need 20,000 more people to get the next 2 kilometers unlocked. And then we need another 10,000. Oh, that's not that bad. Only 20 to... Oh, I do have it. I must have a different one. Anywho, the idea, though, is that we need another pretty much double the population of the city. We don't have that kind of room. We would need to get a massive flat area with our next purchase, and there isn't any really reachable. There's this whole mountain range right here. The sun is coming up, so you'll be able to see. There's this whole mountain range over there. There's a little bit of flat area here and there over there, but we could reach out to about right here, but that's not enough to get this flat area. So... The problem is that we just need a crap ton of people, and we don't have any room to put them. So, and this game makes it so that you can't just cheat it by placing down a bunch of houses and then getting rid of them because of the RCI. So, let's pause it because you do eat money. Actually, we need pipes up here too. How are we going to get pipes up here? Can we jump it right here? Yeah, let's jump it right there. And then just connect up from there. That'll work for now. We need some redundancy, though. As well, power needs to be ran up. But we'll figure that out in a moment. Okay, so we need people to be, or the dead to be taken care of. So we'll put that right there, because that should get all up here. Right? Yeah, that gets all up there, and then we'll have another one, say, down here. Fire department. A big one will get the entire area. And I think just off the main road, like right here. As well as a police department of similar scale. Up there is a little lacking, but I don't think there's going to be that much crime up here that an entire police department's going to be used. So, I'm not too worried about that one. In terms of schooling. Okay, no one school is going to be able to get everything. So, not going to worry too much about it. You can put it right in the middle, leave gaps for water to flow through. I like that idea for sure. And then the archive, that will get everywhere on its own just fine. If we could put it in there, that would have been so awesome. We'll put it right across from the book bank. Just because it can fit there. What else do we need? We need trash up here somewhere. Not that trash, though. actually, up here would actually be a really good place for the trash. Just because it's out of the way, but we need houses. Maybe put commercial up here? And it says it doesn't even get the entire city if it's up there, though, either, so... We have it right there. That will at least get most of the city. And I think that's good. Actually, they'll be making a UE right there if I put that right there. If I put it up there, it starts getting into the city, though, and I don't want that either. That's a conundrum. We'll just put it right across the street from the hospital. Yes, that sounds like a great idea. Waste sanitation right next to the hospital. Just right there is fine. That'll work. Now, the issue here is that the industry and such is going to be really weird. In that, yeah, it's just going to be really weird. So what we're going to do is we're going to park the entire section up first, I think. That'll be a nice little four. Oh, gosh. I don't want to put anything right there. Maybe at the top of this, but not definitely not in it. Okay, we'll put those two there, and that will be just let it be. These will be something. These are pretty steep, to tell the truth, so we might only have twos on these structures. But let's get the four out. Yeah, because that side is irregular, so we just expand from this side. We will at least have four wides, that's for sure. Other than right here, where it's going to be three. park, park, park. Okay, that one could be a four. That's fine. What I'm really trying to do right here is just get an area where there's power running down to the center of the city. Because the power right here is not even connected. Well... Let's fix that. Simple enough. Just one right there, and that should be connected. Very good. Let's kind of jump it right here, I think. I think that's a good idea. We'll put a park there, a park there. And that makes a 4 and a 5, so that's not good. We'll do... three threes. It's going to look a little weird, but... It's not even. It's going to bug me. Oh, gosh, is that going to be... that actually connects through, but I do want to finish off this area. I don't want to leave it half done. Okay, we have one of these little murmurs right there. So, see here. We can have 2 4s if we just put one of those right there, which would make me think the same is true of over here. Very good. Okay, and that was easy enough. Easy button clicked. That right there. Maybe we'll make it a 2 right... Yeah, we'll have to make it a 2 right there, and we can have a little residence right there. But over here will be a park, and then that lines up with that. So we will start from this end, and maybe come in from this side as well. Oh, well. That's irritating. That's right. This is one of the roads that I didn't quite go far enough out with. my fault completely. Let's get the how wide it's going to be. And then 2 2s in the middle. And we don't have a 3 long of that type, which really irritates me now. Oh dear. Okay, now everything should have power now. Oh wait, that's right, because we don't have any power ran up to it to begin with. Actually, we could... Does that connect up? That connects up, right? That does. Okay, so now everything up here has power. We can actually start getting some of the commercial in here. Just right down. This is the flattest area too, so that's actually, that works out quite nicely. So, oh, let's get rid of that little bit, because that's not needed. And just like that. As always, commercial right there, but the residential is going to be butted right up against it. We're not going to have as much of the green space, so to say. So, let's cut. Let's pause it for a second. I do want this to be a little bit bigger. Let's actually make it a 4 deep.
Meteorologists are issuing a thunderstorm warning for the coming days. Citizens are advised to stay indoors.
We can actually have 4s for these side ones too. But these front ones, 2 each, just to try to symmetrical it. You kind of, well, down here just really sucks. Oh, that's right. We did something over there similar. So we did like that and that. And we're going to build something up right there. So, right there. Oh, and that's right. And then it was like that. And then it evened out the rest of the way. Okay, so we're probably going to have 2s on this side, though. To be fair. 4 4. It's kind of nice that that side lines up with it. 4 4. And then, just like the other side, it actually lines up very nicely to mirror, just like that. So yeah, we have a little bit of commercial going up there. We do need residential now. Let's get the backside here actually, because that is actually what was more required. We put a 3 right there. That will be a 4 tall, this being 3 wide. If I do remember right, and if I do remember right, if I just do 4s from there, it should actually even out. And it does. Very nice. Almost have been forgetting the end caps, which is actually very important because it provides a lot of extra park area that wouldn't normally be there. We're gonna have high density up in the front here, or up by the high density commercial. It only makes sense.
Meteorologists are issuing a thunderstorm warning for the coming days.
Definitely citizens low density over here. This kind of bugs me. Just the fill-in, the cutout makes sense. The fill-in, not so much. Just some light taps, just make it look a little less, we filled it in. Even though that's actually literally what I'm doing right there, is I'm filling it in with dirt. okay, so let's grab parks though. And notice that we are actually needing industry now. The amount of commercial buildings that we have placed have actually run their course, and we are actually starting to need industry. One second, I need a drink of water. My throat was getting very itchy there for a second. We do need, or it would be nice to get some ore. Oop, bumped the mic, sorry. It would be really nice to get some ore. I could put a little industry area up here. Wouldn't be terrible. But the issue is getting stormwater off from up here. Actually, up there is actually kind of smooth. Well, not really. it looks smooth, but it's actually still really mountainous. Oh, is that a way down? Oh, we could just dump all of our stormwater off right there. Ooh, I like that. And it's beyond the highway. If we extended the highway out, we could put some ore up there. Is anyone actually, oh, there's a stop right there and no way to get off. Let's fix that real quick. Getting a little sidetracked from filling in Farvale, but it's fine. We are trying to make this work a little bit more. Do we have people stopping right there to ride it? Nope, they're just going over to Mountain View. So, how many have you? Oh, they got a few people. They got 7 last week, 19 this week. So they're getting people. It's not a lot, but they're getting people. 53. It's not a terribly great amount, but it's not terrible either. The issue would be is that I don't have any more room for another city up there. maybe we'd just have it extend from the Strawberry Fields, because that's still industry. So, we'll figure that out in a little bit, but our residential and commercial are actually back up, so we will actually keep on doing that. Again, high density right over here. I do want this actually only 2, as it is going to cliff it. to about right there, I think. Beyond that, it could be 3. Up to here, and then 2 again. Because this side is a little worrisome. That's going to create quite the cliff, but it'll be fine. Out through there, and then again, we'll drop it off. And then we will do something similar with the residential. Those are going to be heavily cliffed right there, I do believe. We'll have this side come out a little, but this side's still going to be very small. And then right here, it kind of levels out. So we will pull it down that way like that. And I think that should actually be fine. That's going to cliff, but you know what? I think it'll be fine. So let's do that. A thunderstorm warning for the coming days. Citizens are advised to stay indoors. Oh, you know what we didn't do? We didn't do a one of these. Now, where we're going to put this, I have absolutely no idea. It says it's okay right there. And I think I will do that. We might need just a wee bit of smoothing on this one. Because the cutout isn't bad. It's the fact that it looks so bad cut out. So just a wee bit of smoothing. Just make it look a little bit more natural. We definitely don't want any puddles, so let's just get rid of that outright. But yeah, just right there. Then we will actually upgrade this road to being this. Oh dear. this is a very long and bridged section of the road. Down to right there, and then we'll need to make a little roundabout spot over here, I do believe. So let's pull this off. We can get something at the 60, which is good. And this isn't actually going to be a road, but it's going to be, but I'm using roads to kind of plan it out. Do I not? What's this? Oh, that's cool. Oh, and there it is. Network extension must have updated. I cannot put it at the 35, though. Can we not have it snap? If we don't have it snap, then it's not going to snap to an angle. Oh, and 35 would be in that direction anyways. Issuing a thunderstorm warning for the coming 3. Days. Citizens are advised to stay indoors. Let's do it at 4. Oh, oops. I was meaning to actually maintain it being level. We'll elevate it too. You come out to the 40, and you need to come up 2 meters. Just like that. The 94 units. You need to come up 2 meters. 90 at the 4, but you are way too high. You need to go down a couple meters. Well, that's irritating. Oh, that's level with that though. So I'm going to go with that one. Then I'm going to say normal, since it does look like it's going down to the ground right there. Then we'll go into this one and upgrade it to this so that it's itty bitty. Same with this one, so that no cars go in there. And there we go, we have one roundabout. Let's head up here. since we can't go this way, we'll actually have it do an immediate turn right here off into... do we have snap? No, node snapping. Why is node snapping off? Oh wow, that goes uphill quite a bit. In fact, the hill peaks out at about right there. This is interesting because the hill just keeps on getting higher. And so unless I put it underground, that might be an idea. Can I do that? That is negative 3, negative 1. That is even. Let's get to a point where we can have it level but underground. That is really far out there to do that.
Meteorologists are issuing a thunderstorm warning for the coming days. Citizens are advised to stay indoors.
You know what? If we say force tunnel, we just, and straight slope, we just do that. And then like right in the middle here, we come off 2. Is 2 enough? I hope 2 is enough. Let's just say that. It is not. Okay. But the idea being is that that's 3 units. I do believe 3 units is enough. We will one direction. Not the band, just the vertice. that changes actually for elevation. I don't want that. It's going to disrupt the ground. I do get this, but if we have it normal. At 4. And that is even. So does it actually come out of the ground though? Is the question. It does. Oh my word. And we can't do that because that tunnel's too close. Okay, never mind. We will maintain this underground. Oh gosh, in the end of the episode, it's been like we're over quite a bit at this point. So, but thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Please do leave a like if you did, as it does help the channel. And do subscribe if you're not already to catch the next episode as it comes out. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, please leave those in the comment section below. And I will see you guys next time. Thank you for watching and have a good one. Goodbye.